Hi, I'm Simon, welcome to Watercolour Wildlife. In today's lesson, we're going to be painting this flamingo. It's nice and expressive, loose brush marks, wet in wet in dry. We've done some detail work in the eyes here, so we will be doing some dry detail work in the eyes there, but should only take about 20 minutes, I think, maybe 30 minutes. So yeah, grab your brushes and let's get painting. Okay, so starting out in the sketchbook like I always do, I've kind of done my sketchbook work here, but I'm not entirely happy with the pink that I've got. To be honest, you can paint flamingos any shade of pink. It doesn't really matter. They're not really pink. They're kind of white. They turn pink from eating a certain kind of plankton. So this flamingo is much kind of peachier, I suppose, than any of the colours that I've got on here. So I just wanted to have a go at getting something closer to this peachy colour. You could use any pink, as I say, doesn't really matter. People still recognise it as a flamingo. So I'm just going to try and mix in a bit of yellow with one of these reds just to make it a little bit more kind of towards the orange side, that peachy colour. So I think I'm going to try a bit alizarin crimson, which is the colour, one of the colours that I've got on here already. So that's that. That's what I painted this with, alizarin crimson, and I think it was neutral tint I used. So we're going to go with that. Tiny bit of yellow. It's not going to take much. Tiny bit of yellow just on my paper there. Let's see what happens with that then. So this is goes quite pink, you know, when you spread it out. It's quite a nice pink colour there. So the mix that I'm after is going to be, doesn't want to be very strong, somewhere down here. See, that's too much yellow in there. This is too yellow, too orangey, so you're going to want kind of more alizarin in there. So I think what we're after is basically, let's have a look, some alizarin and a tiny bit of lemon yellow, maybe a dash more. Once that's faded out, you get some, that's quite a good colour there. We probably need a bit more yellow maybe. I mean, I wonder if we'll end up just dropping bits of yellow in there. So just imagining kind of the shape, I suppose. You'd have something like that. Yeah, it's getting somewhere close. We could try introducing a little bit of blue, maybe. Something that I haven't got in my sketchbook here, but we could, let's see if we can cool that down in areas. I suppose it will go a little bit more purpley. Let's see what happens, maybe. So you could definitely put some shadows in with, yeah, you've got to be careful not to put in blue by itself. I think if we're going to do it, we'll probably mix some kind of purple up. And as I say, it really doesn't matter kind of what pink you end up using or what shades. It's just about getting the values right. So this would actually need to be a bit darker. Yeah, just playing around. Helps loosen up your strokes. Gets you ready for painting, I think. It's a nice warm-up exercise. get to understand. And we're probably going to do that as well. So this is a technique that I've used in the sketchbook here. You see I've painted and then just bled into that line so that it bleeds out. You're just softening those edges and letting it bleed, create some lovely effects. It does need more yellow in this. But we'll mix that on the palette. We'll get, yeah, somewhere close to this colour anyway. There is quite a lot of yellow in it. Let's just try a bit more yellow. Still with this alizarin crimson, touch of yellow. Is that good? It's a touch orange. That's quite a good colour. It's a little bit muddy. Let's see what we end up with. It's going to be somewhere around there. Okay, so let's get started proper. Just going to move my sketchbook out of the way, tidy up my work area a bit, and then I'll be back. Okay, so I've tidied up my workspace a little bit and I'm going to make a start on this. Just move the colour wheel out the way. Okay, so I want that yellow or that peachy colour. So we're going to get a lemon yellow. Stick quite a bit in there. You don't want to run out. It's a pain running out. And I'm just going to put a bit more alizarin crimson, which is here. And then try and get that peachy colour kind of mixing up on the palette, ready for when I need it. So a bit of water in the middle there. Start with some red. Got a nice big brush. It's my number 16. So lots and lots of pigment in there. Now I'm not going to use this yellow. Normally you'd wash out your brush and then go back into the yellow, but this yellow is for this painting, so I'm just going to dip in here. I'm not after a yellow or a red, so I'm constantly going to be mixing these colours to get that kind of pink. And just start testing it. So it's still probably quite pink there. Let me go a bit more yellow. Just get into that orange. It's a little orange. So, what do we need to do to that? That is a bit orange. A bit more pink in there. A bit more alizarin. Yeah. Not entirely happy with that. It's very red. Might just put a little bit of ultramarine in there just to cool it down a little bit. So I have got some ultramarine in that palette already. Let's just get a bit of blue in there. Oh, it might be too much. Just going to get rid of a bit of that. Very dirty. Yeah, I want something brighter. So, let's scratch that. Just clean up your palette. Maybe I want something a bit pinker. I might go back and try some of the magenta I originally had just to get a bit more pink in there. So I'm going to put a bit of magenta next to my alizarin crimson there. Pop that in. Let's try with this. So magenta. And then we'll go back in with the yellow. Not too much, just washing my brush out. Okay, this is better. This is a much more peachy colour. So I'm going to go with that, I think. I put a ton of pigment in there, a little bit more yellow. See, that's why it's so useful to have these little test pieces of paper just to check. I think that is pretty good. I'm going to strengthen that mix. I don't want to run out, so I'm just going to mix a bit more of that. I'm going to stick in a bit more of that. Now, this is magenta, so it's just a pinker colour. Something else I could have tried, actually, is a colour called Potter's Pink, which I've got somewhere, which is quite nice. But this seems to be working. Nice strong mix. Not too much yellow. A bit more. I think that's pretty good. Could probably go a touch more yellow. Okay. Okay, I'm going to grab some clean water. So I've got my big brush, clean water. Make sure it doesn't matter if it's a little bit pink. And I'm just going to paint in quite carefully, I suppose, to start with, just the neck. I'm going to start off on the pink areas, I guess, of the flamingo. So starting out on the head, using a big brush means I'm not going to be that neat. Just trying to drop in that shape. Bit more clean water. And just try to follow as you can. You know, as we always do, these feather shapes. Paint these feathers in, even though you're only using water. I've got a slight pink wash in here. Just paint it as though you're painting the feathers. Let's drop in that little. Just trying to catch it in the light so that I can see. Just put another feather in there. I think that's probably pretty good. Don't want too much water on here. This wants to be nice and damp. I'm going to dry my brush, just dab it off there. Just check for puddles of water, just lift out a little. And any kind of highlight areas, which is basically along the top here, could lift out a bit of the water there. On the top of the head here, just lift out a bit. So what I'm doing is just drying the area slightly by lifting out as much of the water as I can, slightly drying these highlight areas down the neck here. Just lifting out a bit. Now just along that line, what I'm gonna do, so along the base of the neck here, see there's a highlight, looking at your source image, this highlight runs here. I wanna dry that so that when I paint, I'm not gonna get water bleeding into that area, so I'll just maintain that highlight. So rolling up a piece of kitchen roll, I'm just going to press that in there, which I think will do. I'm just going to grab a tiny little brush, just bring this bit of water neatly up to that line. Okay, time to start putting some colour in. Let's fill up your brush, load your brush up with pigment, and let's get putting some paint in. So don't drop it where there are highlights, just start dropping it in. I've got a big brush here, it's quite red. Just dropping in these areas. bit more pigment. Just always just drawing the shape as you paint, following the lines, following the feathers. That's quite yellow. Let's try that little test. That's quite red. Okay, so we want it to be slightly darker in here. Again, just following these lines. It's still quite wet, so it's going to bleed. We're going to get these lovely kind of shapes in here. And there's a highlight running along there. I'm just going to put a bit more colour in here. Remember, it'll dry lighter. Watercolour's always kind of dry. A little bit lighter. Okay, so it's a good starting point. Might want to put in some textures. I guess might want to drop in a little bit of blue, maybe. So I'm going to use a little bit of ultramarine blue here. Make sure you haven't got too much, not too much water, but you just want to make sure that this is a nice good kind of purpley. It's a dark shadow, that's quite nice. So there's a touch in here, maybe. A bit too much water, not enough pigment. Probably need to just grab a bit more magenta in there. Okay, so get a bit more magenta. That's quite good. Not too much water. A bit more pigment. Just dropping in these shadows. Under here. Face. Okay, so now I'm going to do a little bit of splashing. Probably going to use some clean water. So I've got a slightly smaller brush, clean water on the end here. And let's go straight in with a strong mix of magenta. Touch of yellow, lots of pigment. That's quite a nice pink. Just going to flick. So I want to, you know, emphasize the movement in the tail and these feathers. So again, following the direction that they're going in, flicking like this, you know, I want it to go that way. So I'm flicking like that around the body there. Just a bit of splashing around. Just creating these lovely kind of patterns and textures. Something that I did in my original kind of sketchbook, you can just see this area here. So I was just dropping in areas of white gouache into sort of semi-wet paint, I suppose, just to get this soft bleeding white highlight effect. You do get some really nice, I've left highlights there. You could live with those and, you know, just lift out maybe. So I do like this lifting out technique. What I've done is I haven't squeezed that up too tight. I've got, yeah, kind of a feathery effect there that I can just drop in some of those highlights, but I might just splash in a bit of gouache just for the effect that it does give where it bleeds. Just mopping up some of that water. Looking at the highlights on the head here, so I've got a similar thing. I want to just lift out probably a little bit around the head here. And just down the cheek, or whatever it is. Is that what you call it on a flamingo? Is that a flamingo's cheek? I guess it is. And then, yeah, we've just got a highlight that runs along this edge. So I'm just going to dab
a little bit of that out.
I'm going to soften that edge at some point with some water. Just getting in that highlight. Made that a bit fat. I'm going to have to sort that out. So I'm just going to grab clean water. Just try and bleed this a little bit again. And perhaps down here, maybe that's just what it needed, just a little bit of softening. And what will happen with that, I want that to kind of to stain the paper. I actually just noticed that bit, which I probably need to lift out just to emphasize the right shape in the neck there. Okay, so what you can also do, so I mentioned using the white gouache to produce those shapes. What you can also do is just paint some, I've just got my rigger brush, and I want this, using this brush so that it's nice, loose, feathery strokes. What I'm gonna do is paint over the areas that are wet. I've done this before in paintings. If you splash clear water over, you just create a kind of highlight, you push paint out the way. So I'm gonna do a little bit of that. And again, you don't see this effect immediately. It takes a little while. Where else have we got little, you know, you can just put in tiny little lines, just see what they create. You can see them starting to appear. So it's quite nice, just adds a bit of texture as we go along. Just gonna drag a little bit down these legs. Okay, and then maybe just a little bit of flicking. So we do clean water to create some of those wonderful textures and bleeds that are unpredictable, difficult to control, but produce the most wonderful results, I think. It's what I really love about watercolor painting is its unpredictable nature and the kind of happy accidents, I suppose, that you get. That part of me is what excites me about watercolour. So I'm just looking at it while it dries for a second, deciding what I'm going to do next. With watercolour, it's so difficult to know when to stop. I could quite happily stop there with the body almost, let it dry, do a bit of flicking, you know, some white with the gouache maybe. Just painting the beak and the eye. It's nice. You can even leave the feet. Don't necessarily have to put them in. So what I might do is just put a bit of water on these legs. I will put a bit of colour on these legs. I often leave birds' legs unpainted. But, let's just put a bit of water in there. Like we've done with the body. Just going to put a slight bit of colour into these. I don't want too much. I'm going to grab my rigger. A little bit of whatever colour you want from here, really. Go a little bit purple, I suppose. The legs are darker. Let's go a bit purpley. That's a bit better. A little bit more blue. That's quite a purple. And then we could just drag something down here. A little bit of a knee joint there. Just going to drag something down here. Something on the knee. And you could go into, you know, so much detail, just adding little lines. Indicate the texture of those legs, but I try not to get too fussy with legs. I don't want your eye to be drawn necessarily to the legs. It's about this part of the painting, so you don't want to make them too heavy. It will drag your eye down the page. So I'm just going to soften that edge a little. Maybe just a smidge of colour in this foot. I'm really liking it. It's still fairly damp, so... And here I'm just going to lift out a little bit of this puddle. A little bit of a puddle of water there. Just going to lift out. Just helps it dry a bit quicker. I might do some flicking with gouache at this point. Just to see kind of what happens, really. So I've got some gouache here. I don't want this to be too watery. Don't want it to bleed too much. Just having a look at what's going to happen there. You know, give yourself a little test. Make sure you've got enough white on there. And just start putting in a few flicks slowly to start with. Just make sure you're happy. You know, this is where we want these highlights at the top here. It's just adding texture. We can put some highlights around the head there, maybe. Just remember where your highlight edge is. Follow it round. So just working on that edge. You've got these little highlights down here, back of the legs. It just creates these lovely star kind of patterns when it's wet. When it's dry, you'll obviously get a kind of a clear dot, but then that's looking good. Let's not go overboard at the moment. Clean your brush out. I guess some people kind of leave their paintings to dry. I hardly ever leave my paintings to dry while I'm working on them. I might work on a different area, or I like the kind of fine line between painting wet on wet and wet and dry, where you're not quite sure if it's wet, how much it's going to bleed, you know, whether you're going to get a sharp line. It just adds a bit of the unknown, which I quite like. So I think before I put any black on the page, what I might do is just try and put in a bit of the background, maybe. So, well, not background, just get some of these colours to bleed out somewhere. Let's have a look. I'm just going to follow that. And we'll probably have to go in and re-put in some of our spots. You know, bit more of our flicking, maybe some white gouache just to bring back some of those effects. So clean water. I'm staying quite tight around this face. I'm not painting his face at this point. Just going around there. Okay, so there's not much bleeding that's happened around the body. Would have been nice to have a little bit more going on there. So what I'm going to do is just introduce a little bit of pigment. So just, you know, allowing places to bleed a little bit more. Introducing some pigment in here. So, whoops. Yes, going with my rigger brush. And now's probably quite a good time to start splashing again while it's still quite wet. Grab whatever, a bit of pink, a bit of blue, I don't know. Just, and then where you do over splash, it's gonna bleed. And just give us some of that nice background bleeding. I like. Use this on the body where it's dry as well, if you can, in areas where it's dry. It's quite wet on the neck there still. Okay, so I'm just going to try and lift up some of these. I've just got some puddles in some of these areas. Just try and soften this. Don't want edges necessarily, but I want that paint to be able to bleed out quite far. Quite liking that. Just going to dry. I'm going to grab some clean toilet roll, actually. Start lifting out. Just drying off the paper in places. I wasn't entirely happy with the wet area. I don't want you to end up seeing brush marks and... I think that is pretty good. You might try and get a little bit more of the kind of orange colour. I've got my rigger here. So we're back into the magenta. That's quite red. I actually ended up using quite a lot of magenta in this. I'm surprised. I've used a lot of pigment. So a bit more magenta, a bit of yellow. Still very red. Soften that down. A little bit of blue. That's a good colour. Okay, and I'm just going to drop in some of the darker, the shadows, I guess, just to get these darker tones going. Going to put a strip down there. A bit in there. Kind of, again, following the shape of the wings, etc. A little bit around here. I'm gonna soften some of those lines a little bit. This lot. That wants to come into more of a feather shape. And just building the texture. Building these layers. Following the shapes as I'm going. We've lost a bit of the kind of highlight along there. Just working out what to do on the neck there. Actually just going to carry this on down. It's partly where we dried that neck piece. Okay, so now I'm going to splash water in here. I'm not entirely happy with this bit. So I'm going to just try and soften some of that. In a kind of cool way. Just want to get rid of that one splash that's joined the body and the neck there. I want that area to be dry. So just lifting out that bit. There's quite a lot of water in there, so I'm going to try and just lift out. So dry my brush off. Just lift out some of this water. Try not to take the paint with it. Then perhaps just a bit of splashing in the body, just to get that to run a bit more, just with clean water. That's good. I think that is getting there. Just going to lift out a bit more of this water. Might just pop the edge of a tissue in there. Just to lift out tiny. Just don't want it to run too far around the neck there. Okay. I think that's pretty good at this point. Don't know what I'm messing around with that for. Just going to put in some details around here. I'm just going to let it bleed a little bit. Try and get these areas to come up. Look, some lovely feathery shapes there. Wherever I touch where it's wet, it's going to bleed out. Where it's dry, I'm going to get a nice crisp line. So this is what I was talking about earlier, where you're not exactly sure. See, it's bleeding there. Okay, I'm going to leave that bit to dry. Possibly it's a good time to work on the beak if you can. They have a very distinctive kind of beak, these flamingos. What I'm going to do, just, you know, you might want to let it dry and then work on it at this point. Makes it a little bit awkward trying to paint there because it's still quite wet here, so. But I'm going to kind of prop my finger up on my little pinky there and just drop in this with it. So I've got Payne's Grey for this. Just drop in this shape. It's a slight highlight along the middle there. And this carries on round into there. Up there. Now we will fill in that line in the middle. I just wanted to have and drag the paint down. You want to end up with a dark point at the bottom here. So nice and carefully. Sorry, I hope I haven't got my hand in the way there. Nice and carefully. Just get that. Just going to let that dry for a second. So this kind of line here is, it's quite dark as well. I guess that's his nostril. And we'll just stop there. Now, the rest of his face, you can kind of see under here, there's some kind of pink and white mottling. It's obviously in shadow, most of it. This is a little highlight coming across the top there. So we need a kind of a grey and a pink almost. So what we can do is once that's dried a little bit, we can use our brush with a bit of water on it and just wet the area around it. Don't go up to it yet. Just paint in the bit you want grey, but don't join up to this beak, the black bit that you've painted yet. Just get some water on that bit. And then you can join up that piece. So you're just taking a little bit of the paint from the beak, softening that edge and bringing it up into the area of wet that you've painted. Probably do with perhaps a little bit of extra pigment in there. Not too much, a little bit of ultramarine blue maybe just to cool it down a fraction, and you could just put in a bit there. I'm just going to join this line here, let that bleed in. Now I left this line unpainted to start with, just so that what I can do now is, now that it's more or less dry, I'm just, you know, these areas are more or less dry, a little bit soft, but I'm going to blend that line and it will leave the highlight there, but the paint will bleed into it and just give us a little highlight running up the middle there. I put a little bit more pigment. So into my Payne's Grey. Just gonna
drop in a bit more, nice and dark on these edges, a bit up there. And that's just encouraged a little bit of bleeding. You see, it's very subtle, but there's just that line running through the middle there, which I quite like. I'm just going to tidy up the end of this beak. And then what you could do is just maybe just lift out a little bit of the paint there, just to emphasize that line slightly. See what happens. We might go a little bit more. That's pretty good. Okay, now flamingos have a bright yellow eye, so we've got some lemon yellow in there. I have made it a bit dirty with this. I'm just gonna try and clean up that palette. I'm starting to run out of clean water. Might need to change that. So, just bright yellow, bright lemon yellow. One little spot. So it's a kind of yellow iris. I mean, at this size that we're painting, we don't need to be too detailed. Just getting in a bright yellow spot. Just want to see. See, if you use a colour, I mean, in this case, I think it's okay. But if you use a colour in a single colour in an area like that, it's sometimes nice to include some indication of it in other areas. Just helps balance it out. But I mean, it's such a small bit, I think it'll be fine. And then all we need to do once that is dry, now I would leave that to dry properly because it's so small. Leave it to dry properly, and then we can just put a little pupil in, maybe a black line around the outside, maybe something on the eye. There's an eyelid there that we might just indicate, but I really like it. I think it's done at this point. You know, you can mess around, work with it, add more details if you want. You know, you could try adding more detail. You paint these legs in if you want. Go in and just put, you know, they're little lines, generally, kind of scaly skin, I suppose, you know, like bird's feet. So you could put some texture into there. I think it's quite nice. Your eye is focused. Once we put that black dot into that yellow, it will kind of bring it to life. We might even see if we can get a little highlight in there. Just looking at, just gonna have a quick look at the source image. Bit difficult to see, but yeah, there's quite a bright highlight on the top of the eye there. Little highlight, tiny little black dot in the middle. Now, the reason I actually say wait for it to dry, this eye, is yellow gets incredibly dirty, I would say. If you mix a colour in with it, or you put black over the top of it and it mixes into the yellow, that yellow is going to go really muddy really quickly. So you've got to be a bit careful with yellows. Apart from that, I think it's good. So there was a little bit of kind of pink mottling around under the bottom side of the beak. I mean, we could put some of that in. I'm not fussed, really. Just put a bit in. I've got a tiny little brush messing around, really. This is where you're in danger of overworking it and messing it up. I'm just going to put in some of that. Kind of swirling pattern that we've got. And I'm actually just going to soften that a bit. So, clean brush. Just a little wash over the top of it. Yeah, it's kind of detailed, didn't need, but it's all right. So I think that eye is probably dry enough, but what I'm going to do is make sure that I've got very little paint on my, very little water on my brush. So a very dry brush with not hardly any water. And we're just going to put in that tiny little spot for his eye. And we could try highlighting it in my in my original sketchbook, so I'm just going to put a tiny little dark line around there. Got a really small brush for this, but just tiny, thin as you can.
That just makes it pop a little more. It'll also perhaps give us somewhere to put a highlight in. I mean, we're getting really fussy now. Don't think it needs it, but just going to grab some of my white gouache. Again, very dry. Just enough to... So where are we going to put a highlight? So we've got the highlight kind of... There's a highlight coming over the top of the eye here, which actually just adds a bit of contrast. And then I'm going to put a tiny white dot in the eye. Just for people that look at your painting really, really closely. But it doesn't really matter. I think that's pretty good. I'm going to call that done at this point. Hope you've got some results that you're happy with. What I like about this is that you're never going to produce the same painting that I have. There's so much chaos involved in this. You know, water bleeding, me splashing paint. Every single movement is going to be slightly different in your painting. It's not something you can reproduce exactly. It's about producing your own painting, just using the techniques that I've explained. So don't try and copy it exactly, because you never will. So yeah, just enjoy it, and I'll see you in the next one.